data analytics is reviewed mostly on the logistics. Okay, so and also in the healthcare, retail industry, everything is there. But in logistics, the most of the industries are concentrating more on logistics. Even now also we were affected with corona. Okay, so here also the industry which is mostly affected means the logistics or transportation, the Air India, everything is got affected. Even ICC is got affected. Okay, so here the most of the technology or the most of the analytics which is used in the logistics only. So that's a most sensitive part. Okay, what if there is a small technology or small idea is there, if you are concentrating more on that idea and if you are focusing on that idea, if you are creating a product on those ideas, will be the real beneficiary. So that's what I'm showing here. It's in a transportation and also in healthcare. Okay, it's normal energy buildings, everywhere the data analytics. Now I'll be explaining you what is machine learning it is. Okay, so if possible, you just type it in the chat. Okay, no need to unmute and say it. Okay, how many of you all don't know anything about the machine learning? If that's the case, means I'll be explaining the machine learning for next 2 minutes. I mean, next 5 minutes, then I'll explain with the necessary skills to be developed. Don't know about machine learning? So yeah, please give an intro. Okay, sure. So without input, nothing is there. Don't know about machine learning. Yeah. Okay. So without embedded, nothing is there. Without embedded, nothing is there. This is something like a storytelling session. You just assume. Okay. So if I'm taking a PPT and showcasing those PPT, so that's a different case. Whereas if I'm communicating with some stories or some other thing, you may be little bit aware. Oh yeah, this is nothing but a machine learning. Okay. So I'm just comparing a human and embedded system. Okay. Embedded system. Okay. Okay. So embedded system. Okay. The one and only. Yeah. I'm getting echo.
Participants kindly mute your. Participants kindly mute your. You can participants kind of mute your mic. Yeah. Kind of your mic.
So if I'm going to explain about I'm getting it too.
Kindly mute your mic, participants. Please leave the session. At least others will be benefited.
Yeah. Again, the Yeah. Yes, thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Again, I'm missing echo. So, okay, well. Okay, well. Urine is muted. Okay. So now it's fine, I think so. So machine learning. Without embedded, no IoT is there, no machine learning is there, nothing is there. Okay. So if I'm start saying about the embedded, okay. So I just need to connect the machine learning. How the machine learns something. So practically we the humans are all the machines. Practically we the humans are all machines, not only humans. Okay, all machine itself. So I'm just comparing the humans and the machines. Okay, we are having a brain. Similarly, the process, I mean, the machine is having a processor. We are having the memory. Okay, the, what happened on yesterday or day before. Similarly, the machine also is having some memory, and we are capable to identify the colors. Similarly, machine also capable to identify the different colors. Okay, so. This is something like a SoC, system on chip, or silicon on chip. System on chip means the graphical mode, okay, and the processing space. Everything is incorporated in a particular chip. So this is how the human brains are all designed. Okay, the gun is, the eye is directly related to the camera. The nose is directly related to the smell sensor. The mouth is directly related to the speaker, and ear is directly related to mic. Whenever we are rotating our hand, this is something like we are rotating the hand like a 360 degree. Once our brains give the instruction to rotate the hand, then only we are rotating. Okay. Even when we are meeting someone and we are discussing in front of more than 100 people, okay, we will be having some body language. We'll be seeing those people's and we'll be speaking like, yeah, how are you? We'll be moving our hand, we'll be moving our gesture, and we'll be seeing that. And parallelly, our mic works. So multiple things are all working at the same time. So those things are all nothing but technically we can able to see. These things are all nothing but a parallel processing. Parallel processing, or in Java, we'll be saying it's a multiplexing operation. Okay. So here, we the humans are the machines. Okay. Let's assume. Okay, we are at the age of 12 months or 9 months babies. Whenever our mom started to feed us, okay, we won't open our mouth. If mom repeats that feeding process with spoon on daily basis, at the end of 30 days or 90 days or 100 days, we'll be opening our mouth. Okay, so this is nothing but we need to train the machine by repeating the data again and again, again and again and again to a particular machine. Okay. If we are training a machine by repeating the data again and again and again to a machine, the machine automatically recognizes. Okay. Now, if I'm coming to you and if I'm giving my hand, practically your next processing will be rotating your hand and giving a shake hands to me. So no one teaches you that you need to give the hands. But at the initial stage, you learned something that you need to give the hand. Okay. So the process of learning the particular new things, whenever you are driving a two-wheeler, I mean, while you are start learning about the how to ride a cycle, okay, somebody may took around 30 minutes, somebody may took around 3 or 4 days to learn how to ride the cycle. So, these process are all machine learning. Whenever you are driving a two-wheeler for first time, you are more concentrated about the gears. Okay, so now I need to increase the gear, I need to decrease the gear. So this process, that process means you are connecting the data to the machine, Whenever you are seeing the speed breaker, now you automatically slow down the gear and you press the brake, and you press the clutch. But at the initial stage, you need to do all these three things at the same time. Okay, so that process is nothing machine learning. So with machine learning means without doing the code, by giving the data, we need to train the model such a way that it should learn from the data or it should accept those data. So this is nothing but a machine learning. Okay, whereas once I learned something different, okay, I learned something different, or I start recognizing something. Okay, so the deep learning is nothing but the next level of the machine learning. Okay, the next level of the machine learning. Again, whenever we are taking some decision, okay, let's assume I'm going to ride a two-wheeler. So I'm riding in Chennai, but I never went to Tirunelveli. Let's assume, I'm going to Tirunelveli. I never seen about Tirunelveli. I never seen about the road condition of Tirunelveli. Once I start seeing about the different road condition of the Tirunelveli, my brain adapts myself that I need to drive on those road condition, even if the road condition is bad or good or heavy traffic, whatever it may be. Okay, so those things are on deep learning. Once the data is there, okay, we need to see the data in a different way. Okay, even the data in a different way, it should accept, it should recognize. This is nothing but a deep learning. The AI is nothing but the intelligence after the deep learning is processed, or after machine learning is processed. Okay, in few projects, the machine learning is a subset of deep learning, and deep learning is subset of AI. In few other projects, deep learning is subset of ML, ML is subset of AI. Okay, it depends upon the project. So for what I explained is, machine learning is a subset of deep learning, something like that I explained. Here, I shown the screen, the artificial intelligence are evaluated in 1950s itself. In 2000 only the deep learning is start evolving. Yeah, so practically the artificial intelligence even around 20 years back or 30 years back, even 1960s also, you can able to see the AR-VR, okay, AR-VR concept. So all these things are all introduced around 50 years back itself. Okay, the thing is, the process is evolving. Okay, we need a clear infrastructure, then only the ideology can have a valid space or a valid shape. Okay. So after the 2010 only, the valid shape is created for those ideologies. Okay. So here, so this is nothing but, I just explained to you what is ML, what is DL, and what is AI. Okay. So here, these are the necessary skills. Okay. I just passed out in 2007. While I'm completing my degree, most of the companies are concerned about the aptitude, and if you know the database, if you know the basic C program or something. Now, these processes are all different. Now, we don't need any developers. We need full stack developers. Today, we need at least full stack developers. So, these people should be capable to work in the front end, also work in the back end. And he should be capable to do the data analytics also, everything. So industry are focusing more on the people who is capable to do everything. Okay. So, okay. Personal I resume this slide, show please. Okay. Okay, so I think it's the screen is visible.
It's so visible.
Yeah. So here it's shown in 2020. Okay, previously it's a different. Now it's a different. In future, what are the skills that you are having today? Okay. What are the skills that you are having today? Okay, these things are all outdated skills. These skills are outdated skills because around 4 or 5 years back, everyone started to speak about the IoT. I was working with IoT from 2010. Okay. Personally, I felt around 4 years back itself that IoT is almost expired. IoT is almost expired. IoT is capable to build the data. Machine learning is capable to learn the data. But who is going to take the decision? So that's the challenging part. Clear decision. Again, that's the challenging part. So that's the challenging part is today. Okay, so you need to know about more on the neural network, something like a deep learning or AI at least. Okay, and also you should be capable to work with the AR, VR also. Okay, here the complex, I mean, these things are all you can able to get it from Google also. Okay, so I just showcasing you. So these are the skills which is given by the World Economic for 2020. Practically in future, you need more skill set. How to do the analytics, I mean the mathematics. Everything is practically related to mathematics. You should know the statistical analysis. Okay, so the minimum requirements for futuristic scope means you should know the mathematics clearly. The statistical analysis, the probability, and the algebraic map, or any transformation, the Fourier transformation, all these things are all required to do the data analytics. Okay, even I can able to share the screen. Okay, this is, I took a screenshot from the app called Applied Singularity. Okay, even you can able to download the app. Okay, so Applied Singularity, that in that Applied Singularity, the most of the top industries requirement are posted. Most of the top industry requirements are posted here. You can able to see the Google and also the MathWorks and Nikki.ai. okay, here you can able to see the skills required. Okay, for first thing you can able to see the Python, ML, DL, NLP. okay, and second thing also you can able to see Python. Third thing also you can able to see the Python, ML, DL, TensorFlow. So everywhere the minimum required skill is, you can, I mean, I think you can able to see those word called skills. Okay, under the skills, ML means machine learning, DL, deep learning. Okay, NLP, natural language processing. Okay, natural language processing, it comes under deep learning. Okay, so these things are all basic requirements. Now it may be the original requirement. In future, these things are all basic requirements for you guys. So you should know ML, DL, NLP, AI, everything you should know. Otherwise, it's hard to survive for next after the 15 years or 10 years. So that's what I'm trying to say. So here, these are the job postings. Okay, they are expecting 12 years, 7 years experience, and also in Accenture. Okay, so you know, from different industries, you can able to see. And for Accenture, you can able to see the skill set is ML. Okay, next thing also you can able to see the skill set is ML. Okay, next thing also you can able to see the skill set is, what's the name of the app? Okay, Applied Singularity. You just download it from the Google Play Store, and you can also verify it. Okay, so whatever the job is there, they'll be posting it. It's not a job portal. Okay, this is a knowledge portal. Okay, where you can able to get the knowledge in the job segment. Okay, they'll be showing top industries requirements. That's it. Nothing else. Okay, Applied, it's not similarity, it's a singularity. Applied Singularity. Okay, you can able to download it. Again, different industries, I mean, I'm just showcasing the necessary skills. You just see the skill set, whether you are matched with that singularity. Yeah, it will be in blue and green. The icon is a combination of blue and green color. So most of the industries, the skill set is, I mean, even here only I can able to see the MathWorks, MATLAB, CV, image processing. This is a different case for more, and also for embedded engineering. So most of the industries are required the data analysis. So again, in this screen, what I'm trying to show means, okay, we are having a multiple frameworks. We are having a multiple, after completing this configuration, I will share my browser screen also. There I will be showcasing, yeah, these are all the possible ways that you can able to learn machine learning. So once I started to say about the, please learn machine learning, or please develop your skills with machine learning or deep learning or something else. Okay, so practically don't connect to any courses. Practically, don't mistake me. Okay. The thing is, you need to have a branded standards. Okay. You need to have a, you need to learn the machine learning from the standard companies like Intel or, Okay. Like Intel or the NVIDIA. Okay. So they will be posting. Okay. They are also posting how to learn it. They are also posting all the courses, all the materials. Okay. For free of cost to all. It's open to all. So I'll be showcasing that also. Okay. So here, the TensorFlow, the Keras, PyTorch, CafeTeno. Everything, almost all the famous, most of the famous is there. Okay, so the mostly the TensorFlow framework is used in the most of the industries because the TensorFlow is capable to connect with the low-end application and also the high-end API, whereas Keras is capable for the high-end application only. Okay, so that's what how the Keras is different from the TensorFlow. The Keras is a high-level neural network APIs. It's written in Python and capable of running TensorFlow also. Okay. So, you need to learn more on TensorFlow at the initial stage. If you are a beginner, please learn TensorFlow. Next question, you can able to ask me, yeah, if I want to learn TensorFlow, where should I go? Okay. So, it just, I mean, if possible, even practically you can able to try now also. Okay, you just open colab.research.google.com. Okay, if you are opening colab.research.google.com, okay, there you can able to see colab environment. Okay, the colab environment, this is given to all Gmail users. They will be giving around 15 to 30 GB space where you can able to write the code. And also they are giving a cloud space for you. Okay, if you need to buy a PC, I mean, if you are, if you want to learn machine learning or deep learning, you need to buy a PC with a good graphics card, with a good GTX or RTX graphics card. Okay, whereas if you are using those environment, you can able to directly use the Google Cloud. Okay, where instead of normal PC, you can able to connect with a GPU for high data. So you can able to work with a high level neural network also and also your low level neural network also. Okay, with Colab. Okay, so Colab, C-O-L-A-B, Colab, I'm repeating. So I better I share C-O-L-A-B, Colab dot, it says dot. Yeah, colab.research.google.com. Okay, if you are opening these websites, automatically you know, okay, oh, this is the environment to work with machine learning. All the libraries are, all the packages are all installed. The one and only thing is you need to open the session and work on it. Even if you are having a old PC, even with the government laptop, whatever it may be, okay, with the internet, if you are having internet connection with the Google Chrome, this is more than enough for you to work with machine learning, deep learning with the high level neural network for more high level data sets. Okay, everything is possible. Okay, everything is for free of cost. Okay, so now I just continue with that. Okay, so here I just took a screen. Okay, so how the NVIDIA is supporting. Okay, NVIDIA, I mean, even if you're opening this NVIDIA also, you can able to connect it. I mean, if you're having after completing the session also, you can able to connect with the NVIDIA, with the deep learning AI. Okay, they'll be showcasing the deep learning frameworks, KFE. Okay, what are the frameworks that they are supporting? What are the SDK, okay, software that they are supporting? So you can able to get it and you can able to register it and you can able to utilize those things for free of cost. Okay, everything is for free of cost. Even the Intel is also supporting with the AI developer program. Okay, if you are, I mean, previously I shown what is NVIDIA is doing. Now I am showcasing what is Intel is doing. Okay, so in this Intel, Intel is also supporting to multiple libraries and Intel distribution for Python also they are supporting. Thing is, we need to work on it. Okay. So, these are the environment is supporting from the top industries. Okay. These are the two things are environment, water you can, the water will people. So, these things are all available for free of cost. Again, next thing is the open stacks. So once I said about the machine learning, these things are all analytics. Machine learning, deep learning, these are all analytics. Whereas OpenStack is different. OpenStack is it's a cloud operating system that controls large pools of compute, storage, and networking resources throughout a data center, all managed and provisioned through API with common authentication mechanism. I mean, OpenStack is a, I mean, here it's written, I written, OpenStack is a free open standard computer. So this is purely for distributed computing. Practically, it's not evolved for common people, but it's going to evolve 3 years maximum. Okay, within 3 years, it will be evolved because most of the people are the torrents or Tamil rockers. Okay, so most of the people use the torrents. The torrents is nothing but a distributed network. Okay. So each and every PC, each and every system, my system and your system, your friend system, every system is considered to be a cloud. Okay, previously I mentioned in the definition also, OpenStack is a free open standard cloud computing. Okay, so this is something like a I'm showing something like a infrastructure as a service. Infrastructure as a service in public and private cloud. Okay. So if you guys are all public, you are nothing but a public cloud. If I'm connecting to the Google or something else, that's nothing but a private cloud. Okay. So the public cloud is in a different cases there. Okay, even network is a public cloud and the open cloud is also is a public cloud. The OpenStack is connecting with a multiple open source packages. They were having more than 61 OpenStack components. Okay, so they'll be having a Nova, Zune, Cooling, Ionic. I mean, multiple things are there. They'll be using for computing, hardware lifecycle, storage, networking, shared service, workload provisioning, application lifecycle, etc. Okay, so the thing is, if you are using a torrents, if you are using a Tamil rockers, you are just downloading a film. Okay, first they are sharing a movie to at least 10,000 people. Once those 10,000 people are downloaded, this main admin will switch off that server. These 10,000 people are nothing but a cloud. These 10,000 people only sharing to 10 lakh people. These 10 lakh people only sharing to 10 crores people. Okay. So the first thing is they need to pass the data to the public, the distributed network. Okay. Once I'm having an environment like a BitTorrent or something, okay, my system is connected as a seed. Okay. Once it is connected as a seed, so I'm giving data to someone else. Okay. So this is something like a distributed cloud. So once this distributed cloud is working with a proper encryption methodology, that's nothing but a blockchain. Okay, proper encryption methodology and mining, these things are all blockchain. The blockchain is evolved with the distributed network. Okay, so if you are learning more on the OpenStack, okay, for this you can able to the link I can able to give openstack.org. I'll type it openstack.org. Whenever you are getting time, please open this website. We just have a look on this website. Okay, this everything is open source. Everything is open source. The OpenStack is around more than 10 million compute cores are managed. Okay, they were connected to more than 10 million compute cores. Okay, So this is a highly sensitive one. Okay, if you are having knowledge in the OpenStack, your opportunity is very, very, very big, because in future, no need of any cloud. All the PC collectively, we can able to say this is nothing but a cloud. Okay, so for this, the Kubernetes, Cloud Foundry, Terraform. So the around 20 minutes back, also I said about the Kubernetes. Okay, Kubernetes evolved in 2014 via the Google. Okay, these things are all the cloud management components. Okay, here OpenStack SDK is also there. Okay, the virtual machine, bare metal, everything is there. Once you start to see this, if I'm going to take the OpenStack only, practically it will take more than 3 or 4 hours. Okay, so I'm just showing. Okay, what are the things that you need to learn? Okay. So again, so if I'm saying more on the OpenStack, this is something like a landscape of the OpenStack. I mean, the architecture of the OpenStack. Okay, here I said right, hardware lifecycle, storage, networking, compute, everything. What are the things? Okay, well, how this architecture are connected? Okay, I just showing that picture. Even if you are opening that website, you can able to get this information also. Okay, the one and only thing is OpenStack is a more sensitive. So for the data, we need to store the data. For storage purpose, we need to know more on OpenStack. For access purpose, we need to focus more on machine learning, deep learning, and AI sectors. There are two different things for data, for the data. So this is I got this information from Quora. The average salary for a data scientist or IT with the machine learning skill is around 874,691 per annum. Okay, I mean 8.7 lakhs per annum. Okay. This is the average. If you are having a, I mean previously I shown via the athletes is that if you are having a enough skill. You are having enough skill, the minimum salary package would be at least 14 lakhs. Because one of my students, he is now final year. So, around 6 months back, he got a job in CPS. I think so, CPS or TCS, I forgot it what it is. Okay, so for around 4 lakhs per annum. Okay. So, he felt happy that. He said that yeah, I got the job and gave the chocolates also. Okay, the next moment I myself let us start saying that okay, this is the right time for you to work hard and connect with the proper industry, showcasing that you are having this much of skills. You have to market your skills such a way that you need to get a good salary. So he is connected via the applied singularity and connected, and we gave more information and. Suddenly, an interview came. Okay, he's having the necessary skills. So, it took around more than 4 months for him to develop the particular skill. So, he got the job of around in Cisco only. Okay, so of around 19 lakhs per annum. Okay, the next day he came and he gave the chocolate. Okay, now I got the job with the 19 lakhs per annum. Again, myself and my brother said, okay. For your skill, this money is not enough. You need to attempt. So he said, yeah, I'm satisfied with 19 lakhs. Again, he got another interview. Okay. There, he got around 32 lakhs per annum. He got selected also. The next moment, he came without chocolate, but he said, I'm going to focus beyond 32 lakhs. Yeah, please go ahead. That's what we say. So if you are having a necessary skills, okay, the job opportunity or money, these things are all not a big deal actually. Okay, provided if you are having necessary skills, okay, because the industry is focusing the people who is having the skills. Okay, industry is not focusing the people who is coming and just for engaging the skills. So if you are having more skills, in market. You are the best. Okay. And also, I can. So I'll be sharing my browser. Please wait. Share my meeting window. Share content. Is that Google Chrome is visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So here I'm just typing Intel is machine learning space 101.
No, sir. No, not visible, sir.
Is this not visible?
Oh. It's visible, sir.
Okay. So Intel space machine learning space 101. Once you type this, here I'm clicking this link. This is from Intel. This is not from a third party. Directly from Intel. If here you can able to see, this course is, these things are all here. The course is structured around 12 weeks of lecture and exercise. Each week requires 3 hours to complete. So 12 cross 3, practically it takes around 36 hours. Within one week. The duration they give for 36 hours. I'm splitting and I'm connecting for 1 week. Within 1 week, you can able to learn what are the these things. Here they are not giving with any video lectures. They'll be giving the data sets. They'll be giving some tasks. They'll be showcasing some example program. They'll be giving some links to how to do it. One things you have to sit and play with this. For first week, second week, third week, fourth week, fifth week. At the end of the 12 week, you are good in machine learning under Intel platform. Now you can able to post in a LinkedIn or anywhere, and you can market yourself that you are a ML developer under the Intel platform or under the Intel standards. So these things are all market yourself. You can able to market yourself, and also these things are all for you to get a more knowledge. Not only this machine learning. So even I can able to. Here it's a machine learning, deep learning, AI, everything is available. NLP, this analysis, computer vision, deep learning for robotics, anomaly detection. If you want to learn about the AI, at the stage, please learn machine learning first, then deep learning, then NLP, then time series analysis, then come to AI. Please don't learn AI directly after deep learning. So there also you can able to understand it. For better understanding, please learn machine learning first, deep learning second, NLP third, time series analysis, and AI. This is the opportunity. This is a golden opportunity for you guys who got stuck with the corona. So practically you can able to complete these things before the corona process gets completed, because you guys knows very well it will take at least 1 more month or 2 months or 3 months. We don't know, but you can able to complete everything. You can be a best the data analytics person under the Intel standards. Similarly, the similar website is also available. Similar content also is available from NVIDIA also. If you're working in NVIDIA, you should know the CUDA-C. So you need to know those things also. Here, if you know the Python, this is more than enough. You can able to work with the Python, you can able to work with the Java, you can able to work with whatever the language you feel comfortable. So my personal advice is to please work with the Python, because everywhere you can able to connect with the Python easily and in understanding me. And previously I shown, right? Openstack.org. I'll explain that also. So So this is the picture that screenshot I took from this website only, and I shown in the PPT. Okay, there you can able to learn. Okay, so if I'm connecting with the OpenStack components, okay, so to develop the OpenStack for hardware lifecycle, for storage, okay, what are all the SDK that you can able to use? What are the project? What are the open source project is available? So everything is given here. Okay, the one and only thing is you need to connect with the SDK. Okay, proper SDK. Okay, if you are going to use Python SDK, you just install this Python SDK and kickstart it and start doing it. Okay, if you are having a browser, this is more than enough. If you are having a Linux PC, that's then it's very good. Otherwise, you need to connect to the virtual PC. With the Linux OS, okay, where you can able to deploy it and you can able to try it and you can able to connect it. If you are having a OpenStack, you can able to try with the blockchain also. You can able to create how to do the mining process. How to instead of working with the blockchain, creating a blockchain is entirely different, and creating a mining is entirely different. These things are all possible with the OpenStack. Okay. In top also you can able to see OpenStack is one of the top three most active open source project and managed 10 million compute cores. Okay. Around few minutes back only I said these things. Okay, the one and only thing is you need to explore yourself, you need to concentrate more on this. Okay, also I can able to show one more screen, the final photo. Machine learning space RM. So whenever you are seeing about the ARM process, okay, I think most of you are all from electronics industries, or at least you know about something about electronics, what is processor it is. Okay. If you are having a ARM processor, okay, in market they are having a three different processor: Cortex E, Cortex R, Cortex M. A for processor, application based processor; R for real time processor; and M for microcontroller. Okay, so if you have worked with the ARM processor, now this is bit entirely different. ARM is developing a processor with ML processor. ML based processor means, okay, here I can machine ML processor. Everything is available in the internet. Okay, high efficiency, high performance ML inference processor. So they are manufacturing, or they are fabricating the ML based processor. So far we are having a normal processor. Normal processor, we are saying SoC means we are having a processor, graphics, RAM. These three combination is nothing but SoC. Now SoC means processor, graphics, okay, RAM, and also ML capability. The mathematical capability inside a processor itself. When we are taking the data and connecting to the cloud, we are taking the decision in the cloud only. Now we can able to take the decision at the sensor itself. Okay, so this ML processor came into the market also. Okay, so this how the industry is moving beyond our imagination. Okay, so only thing is we need to explore ourselves, and we need to gain more knowledge. And I said, right, I will share one photo. I'll share that photo now. Yeah, I'm sharing that photo. I think you can able to see. Okay, so here we are we can able to see the analytics, AI application capabilities, computing connectivity, data, currency, everything is correlated. Everything is a technology. Okay, I'm not going to say about what is AR, what is computing, what is smart grid. I'm not going to explain those things. Okay, once you start to see that, you need to store yourself such way that you should feel comfortable with the technology, then you are practically your earnings and your self-satisfaction in your life, that will be a different. Okay. So I think I almost gave some intro and gave some ideas about how the machine learning might be helpful. And not only machine learning, the technology. Okay, if I said about the data, one is analytics and another one is computing. Computing means the infrastructure, cloud infrastructure. So two different way I explained it. Okay, if you are focusing more on open stacks, I'm sure that you are the real beneficiary. Okay, instead of ML, if you are focusing more on open stacks, you are the real beneficiary. Okay. So the thing is, you need to work and you need to see what it is, how to do it, all these things. I think I almost completed the session. Okay. If you are having any doubts, you can ask me.
Participants, the feedback link will be provided in the chat box. Kindly copy the link. It will be displayed only for 2 minutes. Certificates will be provided only for the participants filling the feedback form.
Shabarinath, I got a question for you.
Yeah, please.
What's the basic difference between edge computing and ML computing?
Edge computing is a little bit different with the ML. The thing is, computing is capable for those particular, if they're having that web apps or app-based platform, okay, service as used, all these platforms, edge computing is the best one. Whereas ML computing...
No, regarding, I'm asking you regarding the hardware, because the hardware, the edge computing, Intel has got some processing things, processes. What are those things? I don't have much idea regarding this, but what are those processes for edge computing? At the same time, you were telling about the Intel process for ML learning, ARM process. But what's the basic difference, fundamental difference between the two?
They were having a different product, and different companies are having a different products. Okay. So they were marketing that this is capable, whereas each computing is capable. Once I'm fabricating a processor, or if Intel is fabricating a processor, that Intel environment is works well in that processor. Whereas if I'm connecting with the NVIDIA, QC is good in NVIDIA. Not even if you are using a Python, NVIDIA, practically it works. Similarly, if you are having a edge computing, they were connected with some other industries. So based on that industry, we can able to see, this industry is connected. And they were having a clear capability, that's what. Okay. Everything works well. The one. It's based on the application, you can able to say that this is good one, this is bad one. Mostly for edge computing, we can able to say the mobile computing processor is good with edge computing. Whereas the desktop processor, I'm saying about the vertical segment. So the desktop processor might be good in ML segment.
So
anybody
having
any other doubts?
Sir, I'm
Mr. Sabarinath.
Yeah, yes, sir.
I have a doubt, sir.
Please.
Sir, you have some courses in Intel AI developer program. Is that sufficient for beginners?
This is very, 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 very good link for the beginners.
Okay, sir.
I can share a few more links also. Okay. So previously I shared like colab.research.google.com. Okay, there also you can able to learn about the ML. Okay, the Google standards. Here you can able to learn the ML from Intel standards. Nothing else.
I've seen some queries in chat box that whether it, the courses are free or we have to pay for that.
Yes, everything for free at first.
Okay, thank you.
There won't be any payment for anything. So what are the links that add? Everything is open source and everything is for free at first.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, and one more. Sir, Anaconda Spider can also be used for ML by using Python. Yeah, you can even use Anaconda Spider also. But if you are using the one and only thing is whether you are completely capable for handling a multiple data set. If it is yet super, if it is not that much good, then you need to increase your computer. All these things we are choosing the personal, I mean, we are choosing the cloud space. Okay, so you can use the Anaconda also. Have the particular package, and if the version is changed around 6 months back, the TensorFlow is changed from version 1 to version 2. Okay, the migration can easily adaptable in cloud, whereas here you need to sit and do it. Nothing else. It's not a big task, but for the initial stage, it might be big. That's it.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Participants, kindly copy that link. Now I call upon Mitresh to deliver out of tanks.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are.
Thank you to each and every one of you for being here with us today. I would specially like to thank our today's speaker, Mr. Shabarinath Premlal, for your valuable time, sir. You gave us a lot of information regarding machine learning, open stacks, and computing. Thank you so much, sir. I would also like to thank our student branch counselor, Mr. Arun, IEEE Vice Chairman, TEMS Madras Chapter. Information regarding our upcoming webinars will be updated in our social media pages and WhatsApp group. We cordially invite you all to participate in our upcoming webinar series. Feedback link is provided in that section. Chat section, kindly copy the link and fill the feedback form. Link is valid only for 30 minutes from now. Thank you all again.
Thank you,
participants. I hope same enthusiasm will be resuming in our upcoming webinars. Thank you all. I'm waiting this.